The Flying Cross by Jack D. Hunter. Copyright 1987 by Jack D. Hunter. This unabridged recording of the reading of The Flying Cross was published by arrangement with Jack D. Hunter and was produced in 1995 by Blackstone Audiobooks, which holds the copyright thereto. Neither this recording nor any part of it may be reproduced or used for any purpose without prior written authorization from Blackstone Audiobooks. This book is read by Tom Parker. This book is 308 pages and is divided into 44 chapters. The Flying Cross by Jack D. Hunter. The following material appears on the book's back cover. Someone is murdering pilots of America's 107th Aero Squadron, diverting military funds to a secret place for an unknown reason, selling his country to the enemy for a price. Someone who looks, talks, and acts like everyone else. Someone who must be stopped, fast. But there are those in high positions of trust and power who do not want the truth exposed and are prepared to block the investigation, whatever the cost, because what is really happening is bigger and far more terrible than anyone has yet dared to imagine. This book is dedicated to my dear son, J.D., whose road has been so lonely and hard. So stand by your glasses steady. This world is a world of lies. Here's a toast to the dead already. Hurrah for the next man who dies. Combat Aviator's Ballad, 1914 to 1918. From the New York Daily Courier, June 26, 1918. New Yank Air Squadron blasts German base in heroic all-costs raid, by Archibald Whitman. Chaumont, France. Attacking through a dense fog, 8 U.S. planes swept down on a huge German airbase at Metz this weekend and wiped out an estimated 25 enemy aircraft, 4 hangars, and a number of smaller buildings. The only American to survive was the flight leader, First Lieutenant Robert L. Fox of Radnor, PA, who, despite the heavy loss of blood from wounds caused by Hun machine gun bullets, fought his way through enemy skies to the U.S. lines, where he managed to bring his plane down before losing consciousness. According to GHQ sources here, Lieutenant Fox and his heroic squadron mates have made it amply clear that America has already mastered the use of the airplane as an offensive strategic weapon. Fox, who as a 20-year-old is unusually young for the responsibilities of squadron command, is recovering from his multiple injuries. He declined comment on the exploit, which he described, in what this correspondent deems to be winsome modesty, as a routine flight that ended up badly for a lot of people on both sides. GHQ, while admitting that the cost in American lives was pretty high, released aerial photos of the German base, taken yesterday. The pictures clearly show the charred remains of 4 large buildings, as well as the wrecks of many airplanes and motor vehicles. A highly informed source said, "The pictures show rather remarkable results for a brand-new, untested squadron." Fox's squadron was recently formed, the source explained, to perform long-range reconnaissance and bombing missions behind the Hun lines, and the Metz attack was the first of these. Lieutenant Fox, the spokesman said, exhibited the finest qualities of leadership and perseverance in the face of exceptional difficulties. The weather was atrocious, and the Germans were waiting, but he did the job anyhow. We're all proud of him and his men. Conversation, verbatim record by E. Brown, Steno, 27th of June, 1918. Hello, Mary. Colonel, how are tricks? Did you see this clipping? Of course. So then you know tricks are fine. Laughter. Yes, it seems to have gone well. The larger question is, of course, whether Big Boy will pick up on the Liebknecht matter. Any news from that direction? We have reports that the High Command will permit his release sometime soon. These are rumors only. But it's an interesting development because if the rumors prove to be true, our thing will become ever so much more viable. I'll say. So then, why did you want to see me, Colonel? I've brought you this preliminary draft of the letter of intent. Bullseye would like you and your people to look it over and see if that's what you have in mind. The draft has been seen by the Washington element, by the way. Good. I'll bounce it off the right heads soonest. Our reactions and suggestions, if any, will be back to you in a day or two. Is that acceptable? Fine. You'll notice that we propose an exploitation of the Kiel incident, a kind of repeat performance. Not a bad idea. Precedence is there. Credibility. The major problem, as far as I can make out at this point, is to keep General Pershing's people in the dark. We simply can't afford to have the wrong...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.